Hi everyone, welcome to Medical Microbiology. So today we will study chapter 5, Survey of Eukaryotic Microorganism. For the first lecture, we will learn about the external structure and the cell boundary of eukaryotic cells. According to some scientists, okay, the eukaryotic cell were evolved from prokaryotic cell. Just remember that eukaryotic cells are bigger than prokaryotic cells. And remember again, prokaryotic cells are bacteria. Other organism will be eukaryotic organisms like protozoa, algae, plants, fungi, animal, they all eukaryotic organism. So according some scientists, this eukaryotic cell, they are developed from the prokaryotic cell. According to them, this prokaryotic cells, they perform what we call the symbiotic association. So let's say this is bigger prokaryotic cell. So one bigger prokaryotic cell and there is a smaller prokaryotic cells over here. So these two cells, they perform symbiotic association, where the smaller one enter into the bigger cell and stay inside the cell, and finally it's become organelle. Okay, it's become organelle. So this is become eukaryotic cell. Okay, so this is the development or the evolution of eukaryotic cell that actually evolved from the prokaryotic cells. Now, eukaryotic organism, because we're talking about microbiology, so it's going to be the microorganism over here. So we will not learn plants or bigger animals. We only learn the microorganism, the smaller eukaryotic organism. Like for samples, there are some of them that are unicellular, okay, unicellular organism like protozoa. What is unicellular mean? Unicellular mean one cell is become one organism, and this cell able to perform all characteristic of life like reproduction, metabolism, respond to the stimulus, and etc. Okay, so this is what we call the unicellular organism. Some of them may be colonial, may be multicellular, and some still unicellular like fungi and algae. Now, what is the difference between unicellular, colonial, and multicellular? Again, for unicellular, one cell is become one organism. They perform all the characteristic of life. This is unicellular organism. For the colonial organism, is organism that is made of several cells that combine together. Okay, make a colony. Okay, when we separate one cell from the colony, this cell still alive. Okay, this becomes still live cell, and this cell will be able to combine with other cell to make another colony. Okay, so this is what we call the colonial organism. They able to combine with other cell, but they also able to live by themselves. Okay, this is the colonial organism. While for the multicellular organism, this is the organism that consists of many cells, million of cells, like human, for example, or animal, or plant. They consist of million of cells. Okay. If this one cell is taken from the multicellular organism, this cell will be die. Okay, it will not be alive like this cell in the colony. Right? So this is multicellular organism. Okay, so that's the difference between unicellular, colonial, and multicellular organism. So for the multicellular organism that we will learn in this class, mostly helminths, which is the parasitic worm. And some fungi, they are also multicellular. We will also learn a group of animal that is called as arthropods. This is a group animal that carry disease, that carry disease, like for example, mosquitoes, okay, tick, fleas, lice. This is a group of animal that is called the arthropods that able to transfer disease from one organism to another organism, from one patient to another patient, for example. Now, if we look at the structure of eukaryotic cell, it is actually similar with the prokaryotic cell. It is similar with the bacterial cell. It has three main structure, which is the external structure, the cell boundary or cell envelope, and the internal structure. For the external structure, some eukaryotic organism have appendages, which is used for movement, like flagella and cilia. Okay, and also some eukaryotic cell, they also have glycocalyx that could be capsule or slime layer. And the cell boundary, which is some of them have cell wall and cell membrane. Okay, like for example, plant, in this case, because this is microorganisms, gonna be algae. Okay, and fungi. So algae, fungi, plant, they do have cell wall and the cell membrane. For protozoa and animal, like worm, for example, they only have the cell membrane, okay, without the cell wall. Now, for the internal structure, there are some structure that's similar to prokaryotic cell, which is the cytoplasm, ribosomes, and the cytoskeleton over here. Okay, these are the internal structure that's similar with the prokaryotic cell. The nucleus, ER, whether RER or SER, Golgi apparatus, lysosome, vacuoles, mitochondria, and chloroplast. This is only present in eukaryotic cell. The prokaryotic cell do not have this organelle. Okay, this is the organelle that only presents in the eukaryotic cell. Now we start with the external structure. Okay, especially there is an external structure that is called the locomotor appendages, which is the appendages that use for movement. This is usually present in a group of eukaryotic organism is called the protozoa. So protozoa has flagella, which is the structure that used for swimming. Okay? The way this protozoa move is by whipping the flagella. If you still remember, the bacteria also have flagella, but the way they move is by rotate, okay, by rotating the flagella. Okay, so that's the difference between the eukaryotic cell and prokaryotic cell. This is bacteria. Okay, so by rotating the flagella, if it is counterclockwise, then the bacteria will move forward. If it is clockwise, then the bacteria will be tumble. Okay, remember that. And then for the eukaryotic cell, the way they move is by whipping this flagella. Another locomotor appendage is called the cilia, and this is also mostly present in protozoa. Okay, so protozoa has cilia, is hair-like structure over here. Okay, that is used for movement. The way it's moved by like a swimming, yeah, or a power stroke. So they live in water and then stroke their cilia to move. Okay, the next external structure is glycocalyx, and again this is only present in some of eukaryotic cell, like for example some fungi have this glycocalyx, whether capsule or the slime layer. Under the glycocalyx there will be cell wall. Okay, so cell wall. Okay, so fungi and algae, they do have cell wall. Okay, while protozoa and animal like helminths, they do not have cell wall. Okay, lack of cell wall. Now, when we're talking about the cell wall, there are a little bit different between fungi and algae cell wall. Okay, just recall the bacteria cell wall. Okay, so bacteria cell wall on the previous chapter, right? The bacteria cell wall consists of peptidoglycan. Okay, remember that. If the peptidoglycan thicker, it become gram positive bacteria. If it is thinner, it's gram negative bacteria. Okay. Now for the eukaryotic cells, okay, for fungi, the main structure of their cell wall is called chitin, which is mostly protein. Okay. While the algae and plant, their primary molecule on their cell wall is called cellulose, which is carbohydrate. Okay, now look at the peptidoglycan over here in the bacterial cell wall, consists of protein and carbohydrate. It's a combination of protein and carbohydrate. Fungi cell wall mostly consists of protein. The algae cell wall mostly consists of carbohydrates. Then under the cell wall, okay, there is a cell membrane. and the cell membrane of eukaryotic cells and prokaryotic cell will be the same, which is, remember, phospholipid bilayer. Two layer of phospholipid molecules. And of course, there are also some proteins on it and cholesterol or sterols on the cell membrane. I think we done with the external structure and the cell boundary. We will continue with the next lecture over the internal structure of eukaryotic cell. Goodbye now.